Hello everyone, what's up? Welcome to another Lightroom Classic tutorial. And with this video, I want to show you a very quick and easy way on how to get this awesome deep blue sky in your images by using local adjustments and a little HSL adjustments. So let's go. Here we are in Lightroom. You can see this is my base raw image. I did use a polarization filter on this one, but still I think the sky could be a little darker and thus give the whole image a lot more contrast, especially between those bright white clouds and the blue part of the sky. So first off, let's do some basic adjustments real quick. I just want to set it up. Let's bring down the highlights, increase the whites and the blacks as well. Yeah, I'm just keeping a close eye on the histogram, so I don't over or underexpose anything, but this looks pretty good. I could even stretch out this histogram a little bit by adding some contrast. Alright, and then let's also add some vibrance so we get a nicely saturated image. Cool, so that's it for the base adjustments. Now, how do we make the blue part of the sky darker? As said, I first want to use local adjustments for this, as I want to affect the whole sky from left to right. I'm using a gradiated filter and I just want to cover the whole sky just like that. Of course, to make an area darker, we can do several things, like for example just dropping the blacks or the shadows, or if you want to be a little more general, just go with dropping the exposure just like that. The problem in this case is we are not only affecting the blue part of the sky, which is exactly what I want, but also the mountains and the clouds. However, to fix this problem, we can simply scroll down a little bit and under the range mask menu, we can choose between color and luminance. And since we want to target a specific color, of course, we're going with the color setting. And you can already see this isn't complicated at all. We just get one slider and the eyedropper tool as well. Before we can adjust the slider, we need to pick our color tone. So just click on the color range selector. And now hover over the area you want to change. For us, this is the sky up there. And just click in there. Now you can see we have selected this color tone. However, the blue tone of the sky might be a little brighter on the left side and a little darker on the right side. So to make sure we get all the color tones we need right here, we can set multiple points like this by simply holding down the shift key and clicking in this area once more, just like that. And let's do the same on the right side. And this way we have added three color range selectors to the sky. With this slider in a range mask menu, you can define the color range. That means if we are dropping it, it really only affects the colors we just have selected. On the other hand, if we increase it all the way, this gradiated filter might not only affect the blue part of the sky, but also parts of the clouds and the mountains, which have a blue color tone within them. Doing it that way, it's hard to judge which areas are affected. But again, here's an easy trick. Just hold down the Alt key and click on this pin. And by dragging it up or down, you can see exactly which areas are affected. The white part is our sky, and we can very nicely set up this gradiated filter this way. Just like that. Alright, so once we have set up our color range mask, it's time to change the sky. And to do this, again, I'm simply dropping the exposure. And now watch the clouds. As the sky gets darker, the clouds pretty much stay the same brightness. You can spot some kind of brighter area up there, but that's not a big deal. Let's just fix it by adding another color range selector just around here. And by doing this, we are just working our way through this range mask. All right, now that we have fixed the sky, we can also use this gradiated filter to drop the texture, and thus we are reducing the noise up there. But of course, you can also just apply some noise reduction through the classic slider right there. And now we have a pretty clean sky. And that's exactly how you can add a deep blue sky to your landscape images using local adjustments in Lightroom or even Camera Raw if you want. So while we are finished with the tutorial, I still want to keep editing this image, so feel free to stay. I want to continue with the local adjustments. I just want to add one to the foreground and give this little grass field here some more clarity. And maybe let's drop the exposure. Then next up, let's do a little bit of color grading, and I'm starting in the HSL panel. First up in the hue window, I want to slightly boost the yellow hue, which will just give us some richer green color tones in the foreground. For the saturation, I want to boost the orange tones, the yellow tones, and the green tones. And since we have a very saturated sky, I think I want to drop the blue saturation just a bit. Okay, and as I said in the intro, in the HSL panel, you can head to the luminance tab and just drop the blue luminance for an even deeper blue sky. Just like that, we are making it darker. Alright, nice. Now for the split toning, I only really want to work on the highlights. And let's give them a warm color tone, somewhere in the yellow range. Alright, and finally, all the way down in the calibration tab, I just want to slightly change the blue primary hue. So we do have some more red tones in this image. Okay, now let's sharpen this picture. And at this point, we are done with the raw adjustments in Lightroom. Now we can finish it in Photoshop. Actually, I'm not sure if I want to change much here. I just want to clean it up a little bit using the spot healing brush and just get rid of all those poles in the grass down there. Alright, that looks already pretty finished to me. I might check the Nick Collection plugin though, just to be safe. I could of course increase this deep blue sky effect by using the polarization filter right here and just turning up the strength. Alright, I guess that looks good. And let's add another filter and just go with the Pro Contrast and add a little dynamic contrast. Okay, but since I don't want to overdo it, I guess that's it for the Nick Collection. So let's hit OK. All right, and here we have the finished image. So I hope this tutorial was interesting and the post-processing as well. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments, and thank you so much for watching this video.